As I'm being followed by a moon shadow, moon shadow, moon shadow.
This short video is going to show you how to use the darkroom enlarger. We're going to talk about the various parts of it and get you familiar with the various functions that these parts have to get you to produce a very nice enlargement in the darkroom. Now, up until this time, we've been using this machine, but we've used it really as a light source. That is, we set the timer, turn it on, perhaps do a test strip, and then a final print of the pinhole picture, but we really have not used it the way it's supposed to be. That is simply a light source at this point. But we could have done that with a flashlight or a bare bulb or even room light for that matter. So this video is going to show you what to do with the machine when you have to enlarge a 35 millimeter negative. And as you see here, the definition is that it's a machine used in the darkroom that allows you to enlarge a film negative from a small size to a larger size on the photographic paper, thus the term enlarger. Now, for our classroom purposes, we're going to take a 35 millimeter film negative. It measures approximately 1 inch by 1.5 inches, and we're going to enlarge it about 4 times, that is to about 4 by 5 inches. Now, we could do larger if we wanted to. You can go the different sizes of paper, 5 by 7 or 8 by 10. The maximum with the 35 millimeter negative, because it's so small, is about 11 by 14. After that, you start getting pretty grainy and out of focus problems. Now, before we learn the steps of enlarging, we must know the different parts of the enlarger. So part number one, these are things you're going to write down on your worksheet as we go along, okay, just so you have this with you when you go into the darkroom. Part number one is the light source. That is, they actually call it a light head. But that is the source of light, and it's a very particular kind of light. It is not just any light. You have to buy specific bulbs for this, and it has to be treated inside the machine in a very specific way. We're not going to go into that, but you have to know that it is not just an ordinary light bulb. And what this does, the light shines through the negative and through the lens onto the photo paper below. Part two is the negative carrier, and as the name suggests, this is where you're going to place your negative to put it into the enlarger in the proper position so that you can focus it. Later on, I'm going to talk you through how you actually place it in there. There's a very specific way of doing it. But this is what holds the negative that when you put it into the enlarger to keep it flat so you can focus it properly. Now, part three is the locking lever for the negative carrier. And this basically is the only tool that we have that allows us to compress the negative to keep it flat. It's very important that you use this thing properly. It's located on the left side. It's a yellow handle, and you simply push the yellow handle up, and that will allow space for the negative carrier to slide in. Once it's in place, you just snap it shut. You push it down, and it'll snap shut. It also prevents light from leaking out all over the place. So it's important that you are familiar with that. Just go in and play with it a little bit, see how it opens and how it closes. Part four here is the lens, and this is actually the most important part of the enlarger. The lens is what allows us to focus the image on the paper below. Now, it's adjustable. You can go from very bright to very dim by rotating that outer ring, but you can't see that. You have to reach underneath with your fingers and rotate that. And you have to understand that in order to focus, things have to be very bright. The brighter, the better, so that you can see properly what areas that the negative is in focus. After you've put it into focus, then you're going to dim the light down. But the lens does not actually focus it. That happens with the focusing knob. That's a height adjustment. Now, part five here is the height adjustment. And that's located on the right side of the machine. You see it there. It's a yellow kind of knob, and most of the time it's fairly loose. It's important here that you understand you're not tightening this down with any deal of force. You're just finger tightening this so that you don't accidentally move that enlarger once it's in place. So don't really put any force on it. Just loosen it lightly, raise it up and down, and then tighten it. Now, this allows the enlarger head to simply go up and down. That's the only thing that it's doing. And you want to, you're going to see when you're in there that if it's very high, you're going to get an extremely wide field of view, and if it's very low, you're going to get a very narrow field of view. And you're trying to fill this 4 by 5 inch space, so you have to, at first, kind of guess where it is, and you just move it up and down. Now, the sixth part, that is part six, that's actually the focusing knob. And most people use the right-hand side, but there's also the same knob on the left. So if it's more convenient for you to use the left, go right ahead. But this permits accurate focusing for the final image. This is where you do your fine focusing. And you simply take that knob and you rotate it slightly, backwards and forwards, backwards and forwards. And if the thing is in position properly, if you have a 4x5 image below you, you're going to see this thing suddenly come into focus. But you always want to go a little bit beyond. You want to go to focus and then go out of focus and then rock it back through it so that you can see where that focus is. Think of it as three steps or three layers. You've got out of focus above, then you come down to the middle layer, which is perfect focus, and then the underneath layer, which is out of focus. So just rock that, and you're going to see it's a lot easier to achieve good focus that way. Part 7 here are the contrast controls, and those are located on the side of the machine. There are two on the right, and there's one on the left. Now, technically, these machines are actually made for color film. That's why there are three different colors in there. But the only color that we use is the magenta, and that's the one on the upper right. You have to check these before you start because it is going to affect the color or the contrast of your print. And generally, what we look for is this, that the two, the yellow and the blue, are set at zero, and the magenta, that is the upper right one, is set anywhere between 20 and 40 or 50. Depends upon the negative, but if you want to start that way, that's fine. Some people don't use it at all. It depends upon the negative, but that's the only one that we use. And then part eight is the timer. You're all familiar with this from your pinhole work. And this times the exposure for final printing. Now notice there on the left with the picture of the enlarger, I have it set at 3 seconds. And this is what we use to test the prints. We set it at 3 seconds. In pinhole work, we've been setting it at 5 seconds. The reason for it is that extra 2 seconds is that the density of the negative. Remember that in pinhole, we're shooting light through paper, which is very thick compared to film. Film is just a thickness of a human hair, so light will go through it much faster. So we start with 3 seconds in order to do our test. And part 9, that's our last part there, and that is the template. Now this is a size template to give you an accurate 4x5 enlargements. They're in the dark room. You should have one before you start. You should leave it down on the thing. Don't tape it down unless you absolutely have to, because it's nice to kind of move it around and get it into position. And the size that we're using on that template, notice that there are two sides to it. One is for 8x10s and 5x7s. And the size that we use here is for the 4x5 one. And if you notice, too, that if you get kind of lost, on the right-hand side, there are the step-by-step instructions to guide you through properly setting up your enlarger. So that basically is a discussion about the different parts that are in an enlarger. Write those down. These are going to be important for you so that you can understand it when you get in there. It's a lot of different parts, a lot of different small moving parts, and this is going to help you.
As I'm being followed by a moon shadow, moon shadow, leaping and hopping on a moon shadow, moon shadow, moon shadow. And if I ever lose my hands, lose my plow, lose my land, oh, if I ever lose my hands, oh, yeah, I won't have to work no more. And if I ever